Hello friends, welcome back to Apple Friendly. This is video number 28 and today I'm going to show you how you can backup your iPhone to iCloud using iPhone and iTunes. Even though it is a very basic topic, a lot of things have been changed over the past few years, like introduction of iCloud Drive, and that affects your iCloud storage. So I'm going to discuss all these things in detail, and these are some topics that we are going to discuss. And if you have any questions regarding this, you can put them in the comments below. So let's begin. So firstly, launch settings on your iPhone. Tap your name. You'll find your name at top section only if you're using iOS 10.3 or higher. And if not, the setting is little different. You'll find your iCloud setting in the main section itself. So let me hit this name. Now tap on iCloud. And now scroll down. And tap this iCloud backup. Now put this toggle on. This will give you a pop-up. As you can see, it says that now your iPhone will not sync to your computer since you're syncing it with your iCloud account. And if you have enough iCloud storage, you can hit OK. I will show you how to find your iCloud storage settings later on. So let me hit OK here. And as you can see, it is turning on the backup to iCloud. Now it is set up. Now your iPhone will backup to iCloud when you satisfy these three conditions. Number one, your iPhone screen should be locked. Number two, your iPhone should be connected to power source. And number three, your iPhone should be connected to secure Wi-Fi connection. Once you satisfy all these conditions, your iPhone will start backing up to iCloud automatically. If I have to tell you this in layman's term, just connect your iPhone to charging when you are at home and when your Wi-Fi connection is on. Make sure that your iPhone screen is off so that it starts backing up to iCloud automatically. And if you ask me what does it backup, then it backs up everything that is there on your iPhone, including your settings, brightness level, your app layout, your apps data, everything that you can think of. And if you're concerned about the size, it doesn't backup the actual application size. It backs up only the app data. For example, it will not backup the WhatsApp application size. It will backup the data inside application. Or you can say it will backup the game's progress, not the actual application size. And this is applicable to all your iTunes music and movie purchases. It will backup only the reference for those music and movies. It will not backup the whole movie or the whole music. It will re-download everything when you restore your iPhone. So it saves a lot of space. You can use this backup now option to backup your iPhone manually as well. As you can see, it notifies me that I haven't backed up my iPhone since last 76 weeks because I use computer to backup my iPhone and not the iCloud. But this pop-up or this intimation is very helpful in cases where you run out of storage or there is some problem with your iPhone iCloud backup. This will help you to know that your iPhone is not backing up to iCloud and you need to resolve it. So that's how you backup your iPhone to iCloud using iPhone. Now let's see how to backup your iPhone to iCloud using iTunes. So launch iTunes on your computer. Now connect your iPhone using Lightning connector. There's this pop-up. Let me close this pop-up. And now go and tap this little iPhone icon here. Now when you go to right hand side, you'll find the backup section. And here if you have this computer option ticked, make sure that you change it to iCloud so that your all future backups will be uploaded to your iCloud account. This is the only setting that you need to change to take your backups to your iCloud account. I will show you the details of taking your backup to your computer in my next video. And for this session, this is the only setting that you should be changing. Now, let's move on and see how you should be managing your iCloud backup using iPhone. Now, to check your iPhone backup details, you need to tap this iCloud option here. Now, let me tap Manage Storage. Now, let me scroll up and tap this Apple Friendly. That is my iPhone, which is backed up to iCloud. Now, as you can see, all are these apps that are backed up to my iCloud account. So, if I just zoom in, I can delete the apps that I don't want just by putting the toggle off. It is very important to keep tight control on the apps that are backed up to iCloud, because if you don't do so, your iCloud storage will be full in no time. So let us delete the data of this app from the iCloud. So I'll put the toggle off and it will give me a pop-up saying turn off and delete. So I'll tap it and it will delete the data from the iCloud and not the app on my iPhone. So it will not back up the data for this app in future unless I put this toggle on. So make sure you back up only the apps which are important to you and remove the apps which are not important. So I'll keep the toggle on for the time being. And when I tap the show all apps, it will give me a list of all the apps that are backed up to my iCloud. And you have to manage them manually. As I told you, only back up the apps which are important to you. And at the end, there is an option called delete backup. When you tap it, it will turn off the backup of this iPhone to iCloud and delete all the data. So don't touch that button. So this was all about managing your iPhone backup data. Now, let us see how to manage your iCloud storage. So your iCloud storage comprises of your iPhone backup, your mail account, your notes, your reminders, and mainly the iCloud drive. So if you control your iCloud drive storage, you can control a lot of your iCloud storage data. So when you scroll down, you'll find the apps using your iCloud drive. The first section shows Apple apps that are using the iCloud drive. You can put the toggle on and off as per your preference. And if you scroll down more, you'll find other apps or third-party apps that are using your iCloud drive. And unfortunately, third-party apps use your iCloud drive without your permission. So whenever you install a new app, you need to come to this setting and check if that app is using your iCloud drive and put the toggle off if you don't want that app to use your iCloud storage. As you can see, in my case, this assembly app was using my iCloud drive without my permission and I did not know that. So I had to come to this setting and check which apps are using my iCloud storage. So let me put this toggle off now. You need to come to this setting every time you install a new app and save your iCloud storage. So that was about managing your iCloud storage. Now let's go and see how to buy more storage when you run out of storage. So to buy more storage, tap this Change Storage Plan. As you can see, I use the default free 5GB plan. As I told you earlier, I use computer to backup my iPhone and not the iCloud. But if you want to buy, you can buy as per your need, like 50, 200, 1TB, 2TB, as per your preference. If you're using the 32GB version of the iPhone, you should be okay with the free plan. But if you're using 64, 128 or 256GB of iPhone, you may need to upgrade to higher plan. Decide as per your preference. And now, let us move on to the last section, and that is how to turn off your iCloud backup of your iPhone. So in same iCloud settings, just scroll down, tap this iCloud backup, and put this toggle off. And when I do that, I get this pop-up. This simply says that when you connect your iPhone to your computer next time, it will be backed up to to your computer automatically since you stopped backing up to iCloud. So that was all about that I could tell you about the iCloud backup using iPhone and iTunes. I hope you guys liked it. If you have any comments, please post it in the comment section below. I'll try to resolve as many as possible. And as usual, if you like the video, do not forget to give it a big thumbs up and subscribe. Stay tuned, keep the notifications on for my next videos. Thank you.